Following the traumatic events in Tyrone Road, two of Eleanor's closest friends, Emily and Lauren Smoothie, started to think about what they could do to help raise road safety awareness. The idea they came up with was Driving with Grace, which began with a campaign to raise money for Great Ormond Street Hospital.
The name of Driving with Grace came about because Grace is Eleanor's middle name, so we wanted it to still link in with Eleanor. At the time, we were obviously just waiting to hear news, Eleanor, and we knew there was nothing we could do to help the situation. But what we wanted to do, we wanted to think of, keep not preoccupy ourselves, but think of something that was going to
take our mind off the situation,
but also help.
Yeah.
So we made had these Eleanor ribbons made, and we sold them in school, and we sold them at the funeral. We ended up selling them at the funeral, and we altogether raised about £2,500, which was all going to go to Great Ormond Street in the end. And then the campaign side of it, we wanted to kind of get the message across to people our age, because we know that it's most common, like, accidents with people our age, and we hear talks and videos from adults, and it just really never gets the message across. And I think what we really wanted to do was get the message across, but from us, and maybe people might think about it more.
We just sort of want to get the awareness across, really, to sort of prevent other people having to go through what, not just us, the people have gone through, but also like Eleanor's close friends and parents, because it is a traumatic experience for everyone.
A car's a car, it's not a toy. It should be used for what it's used for, not being stupid. If you're gonna do that, then, you know, you shouldn't really be on the road. It's not worth risking so many lives and changing so many lives over, you know, a bit of fun that you're having or just trying to show off.
In a way, it really aggravates me when people drive fast, because a certain mistake, like looking at a text message you just got on your phone or changing the stereo, it can really affect just a certain second of your life.
When I used to see boys driving fast in their car, I didn't really think anything of it and like the consequences that it could cause. But now I've experienced what I've been through and everything, I just think how stupid they are.
Before this accident happened, I didn't think anything would happen to me or my friends. I thought almost that you were invincible, nothing could happen to you. But now it's totally changed, and I think everyone should realise, who drives a car, that anything can happen at any one time.
We're just a normal group of friends. We never thought that like anything would happen to us. We were just walking down a road we've walked down like so many times before, and we never would expect, because we knew him as well, we never would expect that like 2 seconds of just like stupidity could like cause such an effect on everyone.
Well, now when I see people like driving fast, like some people think, oh, they look really good, but I don't think that at all now. I just think that like, they don't realise what they can do and how it can affect other people and stuff. Like, because it's affected so many people, and like their lives will never be the same now because of this.
Of course, Ben Gemmell didn't deliberately set out to hurt anyone, let alone cause the death of a young girl. And that's something he's going to have to live with for the rest of his life. But as a consequence of his actions, Ben is now serving a 6-year prison sentence for causing death by dangerous driving.
I don't really think words will ever be able to describe how I feel about myself and what happened that night, because there aren't any words that you can use to describe your feelings or anything like that. But Once you get behind the wheel of a car, you are in control, and you have to take responsibility for the actions. And I have taken responsibility, and this is where I find myself now in this situation. I don't know how any parent would be able to deal with the loss of a child, seeing them grow up from a baby right up to, but Eleanor's life was cut very short. And to deal with something like that takes a lot, and I don't know how they'd be able to deal with it. So, also knowing a lot of the people that were there that night and involved made the situation a lot worse. So that made things a lot harder as well, to know that I was the cause of what happened and the situation that a lot of people find themselves in now.
For both of us, the the message has to be that a car is a lethal weapon and a potential killing machine, and it's a big responsibility. And it's not a computer game where you just push the restart button. And everybody has a choice. And if you drive recklessly or dangerously, you are making a conscious choice about that. So our message would be that when you are behind the wheel, that you think before you act and you make the right choice. Because just in a split second, you can just ruin so many lives.
Friday the 6th of March 2009 began like any other Friday night for Eleanor McGrath. A meal out, a gathering with friends. But because of one moment of insanity by a foolish, inexperienced young driver, the evening ended in complete heartbreak. It's easy to think that what happened to Eleanor, Jack, Georgie, Poppy, and all the others injured that night was a one-off and could never happen to you or me. But if this story tells us anything, it's that tragedies can happen to anyone, at any time, when least expected. Acts of recklessness and dangerous driving are completely avoidable. All we ask is that when it's your turn to start driving, you think before you act so that everyone stays safe on the road.
This is the way you left me. I'm not pretending. No hope, no love, no glory, no happy ending. This is the way that we love, like it's forever. Then live the rest of our life, but not together.
Wake up in the morning, stumble on my life. Can't get no love without sacrifice. If anything should happen, I guess I wish you well. A little bit of heaven, but a little bit of hell.
This is the hardest story.
We met each other when we was 2 years old, and ever since then we was just best friends, really.
At school, we don't see her anymore. She doesn't sit with us at lunch. And in our lessons, like, we'll turn around and there'll just be like an empty chair sitting there. You think that this wouldn't happen to you, but it can. Like, we didn't think it would happen to us, but it did.
You've just passed, congratulations, well done, but you know, you've just passed doesn't make you the best driver in the world.
Don't try to impress people, because one silly mistake could they would regret for the rest of their life.
It shouldn't stop me from driving, it should just make me a better and safer driver.
I'm hopefully going to be learning in the next couple of months. I won't be driving stupidly, I can tell you that.
A lot of our friends, you know, have said, oh, and I had a little bit of a crash the other day and I was all right though, but I'm really shaken up and I'm going to be really cautious now. But you just think you're lucky you're having a second chance.
It will make me think about exactly what I'm doing and be a lot safer with it. And it's just, so should everybody else who sees this and learns about it and knows about the whole story.
I never want anyone else to go through the trauma and the pain that everyone has been through.
Yeah, so many lives have changed just through a few seconds of madness.
Just want people to really take note of this, because when something like this happens to you, it rips your world apart, and it rips a lot of people's worlds apart. And I don't want that to happen to anyone else. I really don't.
Pretending, no hope, no love, no glory, no happy end.